Starbucks under fire after this arrest of two men, black men, in Philadelphia at one of their stores last week.
The coffee giant now announcing a bold move. It's going to close more than 8,000 stores on May 29th and risk losing millions of dollars to train their employees on racial sensitivity. But will it pay off?
Join us right now to discuss. We've got the CEO of the Black Sphere and Fox News contributor, Kevin Jackson, joins us today from Phoenix. Kevin, let's start at the beginning. Why did the manager call the police at that store in Philadelphia?
Who knows, Steve? I mean, do we really know all the details around that? I keep coming back to businesses can do what they want. There are many places that say no shirt, no shoes, no service, or we reserve the right to refuse service to whomever. So were these guys right or were they wrong? I don't know. But what I do know is this. This was an isolated incident. Starbucks has 8,000 stores, 175,000 employees, and this is a single incident that probably should have been encapsulated in that single incident. I was saying to the producer earlier, if these are two white guys, I'm not sitting here and we're not having this discussion. But now, because Starbucks and we live in this cult of social justice warrior, they have to face something that, quite frankly, is ridiculous and is a cancer on capitalism in America.
Why is it ridiculous?
It's ridiculous because if any single employee can trigger a corporation to have to spend millions of dollars, we're talking about, we did an estimate, it's going to be at least $20 million to give this free day to employees so they can go through millions of dollars of social justice training, sensitivity training that the overwhelming majority of these people don't need. If you live in America, you're desensitized to race issues, gender issues, and religious issues, and all these other issues that people like Howard Schultz and Kevin Johnson want to make believe happen routinely. Starbucks is, and by the way, I'm no defender of Starbucks. I can't stand the company. I think I wouldn't invest a nickel in them. But the idea that their CEOs believe, former CEO and present CEO believe that they have this pervasive attitude of anti-black, anti-whatever, racism against blacks is ridiculous. In Philadelphia, that's a city that's overwhelmingly black. Did anybody look in that Starbucks and say, how many other blacks are there in the store? How many people, how many blacks go to Starbucks daily? I go, even though I don't necessarily like it. I've never been mistreated, and many other blacks go to Starbucks and aren't mistreated. So we have a single isolated incident that never should have seen the light of day that gets national attention. So think about what any corporation faces if one employee happens to do something wrong.
So why do you think Starbucks is doing this? They are losing a lot of money.
I think Starbucks has just, they believe, they got the muscle memory of the Barack Obama era where everything is an overreaction to something racial. And so they believe this is going to help their stock. They think they're being good corporate citizens. Starbucks' job is to sell coffee. But somewhere along the line, Howard Schultz believed that his job was to protect black people. I would say to Howard Schultz and to Kevin Johnson, black people have done a great job of protecting ourselves. We're more than capable of doing this, and America is ready to move beyond this.
Well, it does sound as if Eric Holder, former attorney general, is going to help with the training that day. Kevin Jackson, we thank you very much for joining us today from Phoenix to weigh in on
No justice, no coffee, Steve.
There you go.
Thanks, Kevin.